हेलो स्टूडेंट, टुडे विल स्टार्ट विथ न्यूक्लिक एसिड। दिस इज माय फर्स्ट लेक्चर ऑन माय क्लासेस ऑन माय यूट्यूब चैनल। व्हाई आई चूज न्यूक्लिक एसिड? वी ऑल नो दैट द बेसिक यूनिट ऑफ लाइफ इज सेल। वी ऑल रेड दैट। सो वेदर वी हैव टू फाइंड लाइफ, वी फर्स्ट हैव टू लुक फॉर अ सेल। बट हाउ दिस सेल अराइजेस? We all know that cell is made up of various biomolecules as well as certain other inorganic components. So for the formation, simply we know that cell mostly comprises of three type of biomolecules, that are carbohydrate, protein and fat. That these are why they are called biomolecules, because they are synthesized by a living cell. But for the formation of these biomolecules, there should be some instructor molecule. And who is the instructor? The instructor is nucleic acid. So without nucleic acid, the formation of life is impossible. So we will now study about the structure of nucleic acid, because this is the main molecule that defends any species. Suppose that we are human and other species, just like chimpanzee, we have almost 96% similar genetic makeup. But why we are different? That answer lies within the structure of nucleic acid. So before starting the structure of nucleic acid, we'll first go through the various types of nucleic acid. Nucleic acid are of two types. There are two types of nucleic acid that are named as DNA and RNA. DNA, the full form is deoxyribonucleic acid. And RNA, that is known as ribonucleic acid. Now here is a concept. See, DNA and RNA, the difference is where deoxy. Basically, they are both ribonucleic acid. Okay? So why deoxy? The difference lies within the components of nucleic acid. To get the difference between DNA and RNA in the structure level, we have to go through the structure. So, nucleic acid is of two types, DNA, deoxyribonucleic acid, and RNA, ribonucleic acid. They are made of certain components that are known as, we know that amino acid is the monomer of proteins. These nucleic acid are made of nucleotides. Nucleotides are the structural unit or monomeric unit of nucleic acid. Means we can also say that these nucleotides makes up nucleic acid. That's why nucleic acid can also be called as polynucleotide. Understand? See, DNA is basically nucleic acid. Nucleic acid is made of nucleotide. So we can say nucleic acid as polynucleotide, that more nucleotides are joined together to form nucleic acid. And we have two types, DNA and RNA. To get their structure, we have to go through the structure of nucleotides. Okay? So first, what is a nucleotide? Nucleotide is made of nucleoside plus phosphate that is derived mostly from phosphoric acid. Okay, so what we get, nucleotide is equal to nucleoside plus phosphate. What is now the question is, what is nucleoside? Nucleoside consists of a nitrogenous base, okay, plus a 5 carbon sugar that is known as ribose sugar, okay, plus phosphate. So what we get, we can say that nucleotide consists of a nitrogen base, a 5 carbon sugar that is known as the ribose sugar, plus a phosphate group that is derived from phosphoric acid. Now the concept of nucleotide and nucleoside is cleared, because this is an important question for the NEET aspirants. Now the nucleotide, here we can see nucleoside and nucleotide, what they have common, they have nitrogen base and a ribose sugar. But when the phosphate group derived from phosphoric acid get attached to the nucleoside, it is converted to the nucleotide. Then these nucleotides are joined together to form nucleic acid, that is RNA or DNA, the genetic material of various species. So nucleic acid is called polynucleotide. Here we got various nitrogen bases. Okay, this nitrogen base is very important. Now we'll study about the nitrogen bases. Okay, nitrogen bases, very important topic. The nitrogen bases present in the nucleotide, they consist mostly of two types. Okay, one is known as the purine ring. These are basically ring structure. One is known as the pyrimidine. So nitrogen bases are of two types on the basis of their ring structure, purine and pyrimidine. Now you have to remember these structures, purine ring, always remember purine ring. This is a small n, okay, chota packet bada dhuma ka, purine. This is a two member ring. Always remember this point. Purine consists of a two member ring. Okay, now we got pyrimidine, bada naam, chota structure. This is a single ring structure. Okay, nitrogen bases are two type on the basis of their structure, that is purine ring and pyrimidine ring. Always remember purine, chota naam, bada dhamaka, two member ring, pyrimidine, single ring. Okay, now we got the names. This was the structure. Purines are, there are two purines. One is adenine, abbreviated as A. Another one is guanine, abbreviated short form as G. So purine, this A and G, both are found in DNA and RNA. So if you study the structure of DNA, RNA, then they are consist of purine. And in purine, adenine A and G, both are present in DNA and RNA. Here you can clearly see there are no structural difference in DNA RNA in the case of purine bases, because A and G both are present in DNA as well as RNA. Okay, but in the case of pyrimidine ring, there are certain changes. Okay, pyrimidine, there are three types of rings that are known as cytosine, thymine and uracil. Okay, there are three pyrimidine rings, cytosine, thymine and यूरासिल. बट हियर इज अन एक्सेप्शन दैट यूरासिल दैट इज फाउंड ओनली इन आरएनए. ओके, सो इन डीएनए व्हाट वी कैन फाइंड, इन डीएनए यू गॉट प्यूरिन एज एडेनिन प्लस गुआनिन एंड पिरिमिडिन एज साइटोसिन एंड थाइमिन. ओके, दिस इज द स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ डीएनए. बट इन द केस ऑफ आरएनए ऑल कॉन्स्टिट्यूएंट्स आर सेम, एडेनिन गुआनिन साइटोसिन. बट इन द प्लेस ऑफ टी, टी इज रिप्लेस्ड हियर बाय यू यूरासिल. ओके, सो देयर आर टोटल फाइव टाइप्स ऑफ नाइट्रोजन बेसिस, थ्री पिरिमिडिन एंड टू प्यूरिन रिंग्स, एडेनिन गुआनिन दीज आर द प्यूरिन बेसिस, साइटोसिन थाइमिन एंड यूरासिन दीज आर द पिरिमिडिन बेसिस. ओके, बट ऑलवेज रिमेम्बर थाइमिन इज प्रेजेंट ओनली इन डीएनए एंड यूरासिल इज प्रेजेंट ओनली इन आरएनए. थाइमिन इज एब्सेंट इन आरएनए, यूरासिल इज एब्सेंट इन डीएनए. दिस इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर नीट स्टूडेंट्स. ओके, नाउ गेट बैक टू द स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ दिस बेसिस. जस्ट इट इज फॉर योर इंफॉर्मेशन, यू डोंट नीड ऑलवेज टू रिमेम्बर द रिंग स्ट्रक्चर्स. I am just drawing. So first we will start with the structure of purine rings. Okay, students, purine ring structure. First purine is our adenine. Okay. Here is a double membered ring. See, this is the structure of adenine. Always remember, this is also known as 6-aminopurine. Why? Because the sixth position consists of an amino group. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay? 6-aminopurine. This is the structure of adenine base. Now we'll study the structure of guanine. The structure of here there is a certain change. Always remember the side ring structure remains the same. There is no change in the side ring. Okay? Sorry. Here you can see there is a amino group is changed. That was present in the sixth position in the case of adenine. This is present here. And there is a keto group is present. This is the structure of G. There are no changes in the side chain. Okay, this was the structure of purine bases. Okay, now study the structure of pyrimidine bases. How many pyrimidine bases we have got? We have cytosine, uracil and thymine. We will study one by one. First, I am starting with cytosine. Always remember, these are single membered ring. Okay, here you can see In the case of pyrimidine cytosine, there is simply in H2 group is present. This is the structure of cytosine. Okay. Now, if we have to change cytosine to uracil, okay. Next, we will study the structure of uracil. In the case of uracil, you simply have to change here. See, this is the structure of uracil. And from uracil to thymine, if you have to go uracil to thymine, you just need to add here a methyl group. When you add a methyl group, uracil becomes thymine. Okay? This is uracil, this is thymine. Clear? These are the structures of various purine and pyrimidine bases. Now we'll go in more details. You have now idea about nucleotide and nucleoside. Nucleic acid is made of nucleotides, that also called as polynucleotide. Nucleotide is made of nucleoside plus a phosphate group. Okay, and that consists of a ribose. Now we get back to the structure of ribose. Ribose is basically a 5-carbon chain. See, this is a 5-carbon sugar, ribose sugar, that is the main constituent of nucleoside. Here in the case of RNA, that is known as beta D ribose. Okay, the second prime position, OH group is present, but when we study about the structure of DNA, suppose we have to now draw the DNA. DNA is known as deoxyribose. Clearly see, deoxy, dehydration, degradation. Simply where you get D, that simply means removal. Okay, deoxy. Ribonucleic acid. Ribonucleic acid. In the case of ribonucleic acid, RNA, you get same the pentose sugar structure. Now here we study DNA. DNA means deoxyribonucleic acid. Deoxy. D means removal. Removal kiska? Oxy. Oxy for kiska? Oxygen. So here we just simply remove this O. Now this is the constituent of DNA. Clear? 2 prime, second prime position mein oxygen remove kar diya, this is DNA. If present, that is RNA, deoxy, where in the second carbon position, 2 prime. Okay, clear? So always remember in the classes of NEET, DNA, the bases are adenine, guanine, that are purine, and here that are pyrimidine. Now we will get about the bonding. How they bond? See, bonding is very important for any chemical structure to be integrated. Okay? DNA should be highly stable. Okay? So for the stability of DNA, the purine and pyrimidine bases are joined together to form nucleic acid. Now, how is the joining works? In the case of DNA on RNA, this is universal, always one purine added with a pyrimidine. A always pair with T. But if it is RNA, you will find a AU pairing. Okay? And here G always pair with C. Now you can see there is a three line, here is a two line. This simply means number of hydrogen bond. Okay, the purine and pyrimidine bases are joined together by hydrogen bond. In the case of DNA, adenine binds with thymine with two hydrogen bond, guanine binds with cytosine with three hydrogen bonds. That simply reminds us G triple bond C is more stable as compared to A double bond T. Simple, सोचो आपके पास दो stick है, okay? उसको break करना ज्यादा easy होगा, या तीन stick है तो उसको break करना relatively ज्यादा मुश्किल होगा. Means G triple bond C, GC content in any DNA molecule जितना भी ज्यादा होगा, that DNA should be more stable. Okay? So GC content is very much a component that is necessary for the stability of DNA. There are also many other factors, sugar cracking and others, that we'll study later. Okay? So remember, A always pairs with T. In the case of RNA, A pairs with U, and GC will be remain same, either DNA or RNA. Clear? Now here is question arises that comes from Chargaff's principle. There are various question arises from this Chargaff's principle in NEET exam. Chargaff was a scientist who made many calculations about the structure. Always remember, first of all, the Chargaff's principle is only applicable for double helical DNA. Okay, Chargaff's principle is applicable only for double helical DNA. For whom? Double helical DNA. So here is a question. In the case of single stranded RNA genome or single stranded DNA genome that you can find in the case of virus, should not follow Chargaff's principle. Okay? In the case of viral genome, not follows Chargaff principle. Clear? Because that mostly comprises either of a RNA genome or a single stranded DNA genome. This is specifically for double helical DNA. Now, what Chargaff said? According to Chargaff's principle, the molar ratio of S to T should be 1. Okay? And C to G should be 1. Okay? A always pairs with T. C always pairs with G. Okay? So the number of A plus T should be equal to the number of C to G. But that does not necessarily mean that the number of purines should always be equal to the number of pyrimidines. Clear? The molar ratio of A to T should always be 1. C to G should always be 1. From here, let me explain this with a simple problem. Okay? Because this problem comes in many entrance exams. Suppose there is a DNA sample that contains cytosine equal to 30%. Okay? Now you have to get what is the molar ratio of A, T and G. Okay? We all know that the number of purines will be the number of pyrimidines. Okay? A plus A double bond T plus G, simply got the content total is 100%. We got the molar ratio of C is 30%. So A plus T plus 30 plus 30 equal to 100%. Why I take the same? Because previously I told you that A is to T molar ratio is 1. And the molar ratio of G and C is 1. So if the content of C is 30%, we can write the content of G also 30%. Means A plus T equal to 100 minus 60 equal to 40%. In the place of T, I can write A, means 2A equal to 40. So, A equal to 20%. Clear? So, if you know the concentration of molar concentration of any of the purine or pyrimidine bases, you can derive all the components. Okay, always remember the molar ratio of A is to T is to 1 and G is to C is equal to 1. Clear? Okay. Nucleic acid is very important basic conceptual topic that consists of many small relativity topics that are equally important. Now, another section that is very important for you to remember the name of nucleic acids, nucleotide as well as nucleoside. See, nucleosides in RNA will first got what? There are purines and pyrimidines. In purine, we got A and G. So, first nucleoside in RNA is adenine called adenosine. In the case of guanine, it is called guanosine. In the case of C, it is called cytidine. In the case of, here you can see, here U or T, but as I wrote nucleoside in RNA, here we take U. That is called uridine. Okay? In the case of purine, in nucleoside in RNA, A is called adenosine, G is called guanosine, C is called cytidine, U is called uridine. As in the same in the case of DNA, just add deoxy, deoxyadenosine, deoxyguanosine, deoxycytidine. But in the case of uridine, here we know that in DNA U is absent, T is present. So, that should be deoxythymidine. Clear? See, just when we are studying about the nucleoside in RNA that are adenosine, in the case of guanine that is called guanosine, in the case of C that is called cytidine, in the case of U that is called uridine as T is absent, just in the case of DNA, just add deoxy to all of them and change U to T, thymidine. Now, here the basic remains same. We study the nucleotides in RNA and DNA. Nucleotides means the phosphate group is added. Nucleotide that consists of nucleoside plus a phosphate group derived from a phosphoric acid. Now get the name. First, in the case of A, that is known as adenylate. In the case of G, that is known as guanylate. Okay. In the case of C, that is known as cytidylate. N and D, nylate, dilate. Okay. Always remember, in the case of purines, the abbreviation in last should be nylate. In the case of pyrimidine, that should be dilate. Cytidylate and uridylate. In the case of DNA, thus as deoxy, the whole procedure remains same. And here, that is changed to T, deoxythymidylate. Clear? Adenylate, guanylate, cytidylate, uridylate. In the case of purines, the bases should be nylate. In the case of pyrimidine, the name of the bases should be dilate. Clear? These are the basic purine and pyrimidines. And from the beginning, I always talking about polynucleotide. Just I will give you a basic information about polynucleotide. In next lecture, when we study the structure of DNA, there we go to the details. Just simply remember nucleotide. Just see, this is a phosphate group. Okay, this is added to the CH2 group of pentose sugar. Okay, and it is added with the four member ring to the ninth position. This is a structure of simply a nucleotide. Okay, phosphate group is added to pentose sugar along with the nitrogen base. Nitrogen base ke sath ye kahan add hoga? On the ninth position. See, in the pentose sugar, that is the five carbon, fifth carbon mein yahan pe kya present tha? CH2OH, that is eliminated. So how polynucleotides are formed? Simply remember, polynucleotide means many nucleotides are joined together. How they join? They simply joined by the 5 prime phosphate of one nucleotide to 3 prime OH of another nucleotide. How polynucleotides are formed? The 5 prime phosphate group of one nucleotide is joined with the 3 prime OH of another nucleotide. So how they join? There is basically a elimination. Kiska elimination? Elimination of a water molecule means this simply is a condensation reaction. And by the condensation, the bond formed between the nucleotides that help them to form polynucleotide. This bond is known as phosphodiester bond. Remember the name. Phosphodiester bond. So within a polynucleotide, the nucleotides are joined together by phosphodiester bond. Okay? How they are joined together? By phosphodiester bond. Clear? And how this phosphodiester bond is formed? Between the 5 prime phosphate of one nucleotide and the 3 prime OH end of another nucleotide, there is a condensation reaction occurs and a water molecule is removed. Okay? This is just simple like alcohol esterification. Clear? And in the case of nucleoside, remember the pentose sugar and nitrogen bases are joined together by glycosidic bond. I am writing this on behalf of you. In nucleoside, that is made of nitrogen base plus a pentose sugar, 5 carbon sugar is pentose sugar, that is ribose. They are joined together by glycosidic bond. Okay, but in the case of nucleotide, that along with that is made of nucleoside plus phosphate, here the nucleotides are joined by phosphodiester bond. Okay students, so this is all for today. In next lecture, we will study about the structure of DNA. If you have any doubt or any problem, you can mention that in comment section. Okay, thank you.